Not too long ago, Formula 1 had its first race of the 2021 season in Bahrain. It was an electrifying showdown, pretty darn interesting to watch, and even the FIA's trademark inconsistency already showed. Anyways, this very race got my excitement soaring, and the 3 weeks gap until the next felt way too long. Therefore, I decided to hop into my simulator, or rather Assetto Corsa to be more precise, since Racing Studios already released their 2021 Formula 1 car mod and a first version of Formula 1's newest edition, the Saudi Arabian Jeddah Street Circuit, was published in Racedepartment. So, in this video, I'm gonna showcase a race against the AI on this very circuit and go over my thoughts about the RSS 2021 cars, as well as the modded version of the Jeddah Circuit, which isn't entirely limited to the Assetto Corsa implementation. First of all, let's talk a bit about Jeddah and how its modded version in AC plays out. When plans of its channel layout emerged, the Formula 1 community was scared of yet another boring city circuit where overtaking will be nearly impossible, like in Monaco, for example. Additionally, it was just last year that Formula 1 announced the Vietnamese Grand Prix, which is also a city circuit. Now, at first, I shared the same fears, but after giving the track a go in Assetto Corsa, I'm a bit less anxious about how the actual Grand Prix will play out. Now, before I go into more detail why that's the case, I just quickly wanted to credit Nuke Drop, the creator of the modded Jeddah circuit, on his excellent work. Firstly, racing on his implementation felt amazing, and apart from some very minor inconveniences, like strange shading on distant buildings in the background scenery, this track could easily have been published by Kunos themselves. The only noticeable difference to the track showcase published on Formula 1's YouTube channel is that it seems to be a bit tighter than in his version. Additionally, and I highly respect his decision here, he chose to surface the walls surrounding the track with banners reading the F1 slogan, "We race as one," as well as others regarding human rights, as they are, well, pretty minimalistic there. Will this change anything? No, probably not. But it's a nice touch in my opinion. To come back to the actual racing context though, I feel like the track actually has some potential for overtakes, especially in the last sector, as the penultimate straight feels like it's continuing forever. The only problem will probably be following another car through the whole of Sector 1, as it's way too downforce reliant to allow anyone to stay close to the car in front. However, the crucial part will be the tiny left kink in the middle of the backstraight, as it just about isn't flat out, which means the car behind will significantly lose out again. And whether anyone will be able to close this gap again until the end of the straight, well, only time will tell. Secondly, my main point of focus lies on the 2021 Formula Hybrid cars by Racing Studios. Most of you, also somewhat interested in Assetto Corsa, should already be familiar with their brand, as they are in the business for an eternity now and continuously publish a new generation of Formula 1 cars year after year ever since 2017. Now, regarding the handling aspects, I can only say as much as they are usually a lot better and more fun to drive than the actual cars in the F1 series, which is probably also partly due to AC superiority. And as someone that is more into GT than Formula Racing, regarding sim racing, I really didn't spot too much of a difference between the 2020 model and the new 2021 generation. Although they lost a ton of downforce due to the new floor regulations and are now slower than their predecessors. On that note, I'd say definitely give the modded Jeddah track a try, evaluate it for yourself, and let me know your predictions of how you think this year's Formula 1 race will go down, and whether there'll be any overtakes. Also, if you have some money to spare, about 5 euros to be more precise, the RSS Formula 1 cars are once again of high quality and a joy to drive. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video or got something useful out of it. And if that's the case, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!